Hi, this is just a short video on a sit stay command, or a sit stay. When I give a command, I expect my dog simply to wait in that position. If I give them a sit, I expect them to simply stay there. That sit is a stay until I tell them it's okay to come out of. What they may do if I have them in a sit, they may lay down, but basically they aren't allowed out of this area. So I can stop, the dog knows that it needs to sit when I stop. I could be walking along, meet somebody, stop, the dog will sit, I can have a chat, and I can talk to this person for 5 minutes or 10 minutes. The dog will chill and lay down here beside me, in a stay. I can lead the dog. If the dog's in a sit, again it can go down into a down position, but it must stay in that position. I can distract it, move around it, and it doesn't really matter. Until I get the command, I expect the dog simply to be there. So this allows me to stop the dog sit, or me put the dog into a sit, go and open the gate or go and do something else, and the dog is safe. Kaji, sit. Kaji, sit. Good boy. So how do I do that? Basically, I start this as soon as the dog knows the basic sit. So as soon as he's got the idea of sit, I start adding this in. So I'll get him to sit. And I'll actually make him fail a couple of times just so you can see the corrections. But I'll get him to sit, and then I'll just begin to fake coming forward a little bit. When the dog does, I'll just guide him back to beside me and give that little command. Good boy. And then praise him when he's come back. I'll keep doing that until I get this. There's no movement from him. When there's no movement from him, I'll start to take a slightly bigger step. And if he begins to come forward, the same thing. I'll control that comeback with the up command and correct him. If I can get here and I can come back and he hasn't, good boy, I'll treat him. Once I've got that far, I'll simply step around in front of him. Good boy. Yes. And again, I control the lead, so if he begins to come forward, I can just keep him in position, come back beside him, and also correct him. When he's doing the right thing, I just come out, I come back, good boy, and I correct him, I praise him and treat him once I'm back beside him. The main reason for that is I don't want to be out here and he sees me coming, he knows I'm coming back, so he gets excited, jumps up and comes towards me thinking that it's over. I want to be right here next to him when it does, when it is over. So, Koji, sit. As you can see, he knows his job is just to chill, and so if he's not doing anything, he'll just lay down. Right, so once I've got this where I can just come around in front of him, I'll just step off a little more, come around, I'll step back. Good boy. So I'll just increase that distance a little bit, nice and slowly. And like everything else, with whatever interaction I have with him, it's nice and calm. My movements are slow, they're nice and calm. If I suddenly go, he'll go with me. Until he knows it. Now it just doesn't matter. He'll wait until I give the command. Once you've got that, I'm assuming you're in a safe area, so and the dog is very comfortable doing this because you don't want the dog to fail, you can let go of the lead. And then you can start it all over again until you get to this point, and then you just slowly increase it. The moment you see any movement from the dog, you watch his body, and if there's any indication that he's going to come up, and there he's just actually thinking I'm trying to give him the treat, you correct, come back beside him, and go again. When your shore is comfortable, you just slowly increase that. So eventually you just walk. You do what you need to do. You come back. Hopefully the dog's still here.
Good boy.
You praise and treat. Hope that helps. Thank you.